Hello dear students, we have to understand what are trigonometric ratios. So for that, first let me draw a right angle triangle. Suppose this is a right angle triangle, right angled at point B. This is a triangle ABC, right angled at point B. And we know that if there is a right angle triangle, then there is a base, a perpendicular and hypotenuse. So with the respect of these three sides, perpendicular, base or hypotenuse, we can write six trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric ratios means ratios of sides. Since we have three sides, then we can write six ratios including sides, and these six ratios are called trigonometric ratios. Let me write in terms of perpendicular, hypotenuse and base. First ratio may be perpendicular upon hypotenuse, second may be base upon hypotenuse, third is perpendicular upon base, then fourth hypotenuse upon perpendicular, fifth hypotenuse upon base, and sixth base upon perpendicular. These are six ratios including sides of a right angle triangle in terms of perpendicular, base and hypotenuse, and these six ratios are called six trigonometric ratios. They are very important. For any triangle there may be six trigonometric ratios. Now we have to name them. So first ratio, which is perpendicular by hypotenuse, is known as sine, S-I-N-E. Second is base by hypotenuse, it is cosine. Third is perpendicular by base, that is tangent. Next is hypotenuse by perpendicular, that is cosecant. Next is hypotenuse by base, this is secant. Last is base by perpendicular, and this is cotangent. Nowadays these ratios are called sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, cotangent. Whenever we have to discuss about perpendicular by hypotenuse, we'll call it as sine. Whenever we have to discuss about perpendicular by base, we'll call it tangent. And also now their abbreviation are like S-I-N-E, sine is now we use S-I-N, sine, for this. For cosine we write just cos, for tangent we write just tan, for cosecant we write just cosec, for secant we write just sec, for cotangent we write just cot. So these are short form of trigonometric ratios, their names: sine, cos, tangent, cosec, sec and cot. Whenever we have to discuss about hypotenuse and base, we will take it as sec. Now coming to figure, our figure, which is ABC, triangle ABC, right angled at B. So when we define an angle, when we define an acute angle, then only we'll able to tell that which is base and which is perpendicular. Hypotenuse is fixed. If there is a right angle triangle, then side opposite to right angle is always hypotenuse. So for this triangle, side AC, is hypotenuse. Now for angle A, perpendicular is BC. The side opposite to acute angle about which we are discussing, with respect to which we are writing the trigonometric ratios, the side opposite to that angle is always perpendicular. And the side adjacent to angle other than hypotenuse is base. So for angle A, perpendicular is BC, base is AB and hypotenuse is AC. So if we define an angle, then we can write the value of sine, cos, tan and so on for a particular triangle. So if I name this angle as theta, suppose this is angle theta, then sine for this angle, sine means trigonometric ratio, sine is a trigonometric ratio, for this angle theta is called sine theta. This is very important. Sine theta means sine of angle theta. So sine of angle theta will be, we know that sine of any angle is perpendicular by hypotenuse. So this is formula for sine, perpendicular by hypotenuse. But now we are discussing about angle theta. So for this triangle, sine theta will be BC upon AC. So when we define an angle, then only we can say that this is perpendicular or hypotenuse or base for this particular angle. So angle is very important. All trigonometric ratios are always written with respect to some angle. With respect to some angle only, we can say that this is perpendicular, this is base. Now cos theta. Cos theta means cosine of angle theta. So cos theta is base by hypotenuse. The ratio base by hypotenuse is called cos. So cos for this theta will be, now base is AB and hypotenuse is AC. Because we defined theta as angle A, so we are writing AB in place of base and hypotenuse is AC. Now tan theta. Tan is perpendicular by base. So perpendicular for this angle is BC. So tan theta is BC upon AB. Now cosec theta. Cosec is hypotenuse by perpendicular and hypotenuse is AC. So AC by perpendicular. Perpendicular is BC. Now sec theta. Sec is hypotenuse by base and hypotenuse is AC, base is AB. So sec theta is AC upon AB. Now last is cot theta. Cot is base upon perpendicular and base for angle theta is AB and perpendicular is BC. So these are six possible trigonometric ratios. If we just think about perpendicular, hypotenuse or base, then we can write these six ratios and these are six trigonometric ratios and sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot are their names. And with respect to this triangle, for example, if I have taken this triangle, so with respect to this triangle and for this angle, the values of sine theta, cos theta, tan theta and so on are these. Sine theta is BC by AC and so on. So angle is very important. All trigonometric ratios are defined for some particular angle only. That angle is acute in our syllabus. Now, if we observe, we can see that these two ratios, sine and cosec, sine is perpendicular by hypotenuse and cosec is hypotenuse by perpendicular. So we can see perpendicular by hypotenuse and hypotenuse by perpendicular are basically reciprocal of each other. So we can say cosec theta, cosec for any angle is reciprocal of sine. So cosec theta is always 1 by sine theta, or we can say sine theta is reciprocal of cosec. So sine theta is also written as 1 by cosec theta. Similarly, we can see this base by hypotenuse and hypotenuse by base are reciprocal of each other. It means sec theta is equal to 1 by sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. It is reciprocal of cos. And perpendicular by base, base by perpendicular are also reciprocal of each other. So we can say tan theta and cot theta are reciprocal of each other. It means cot theta can be written as 1 by tan theta. So we can say we have very simple formula or simple identities in terms of cosec, sec, cot, that cosec is reciprocal of sine. So cosec theta is 1 by sine theta. Whenever we get the value of sine theta, we have to just make the reciprocal of it and we'll got the value of cosec theta. Reciprocal of cos theta is sec theta. Reciprocal of tan theta is cot theta. Also, if we divide this ratio base by hypotenuse by perpendicular by hypotenuse, if we divide this, so hypotenuse hypotenuse get cancelled and we will have just perpendicular by base, and which is value of this tan theta. So if we divide perpendicular by hypotenuse by base by hypotenuse, means if we divide sin theta by cos theta, we get tan theta. So this is again a very important formula, that tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Means we can write tan theta in terms of sin theta and cos theta as tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Now cot theta is reciprocal of tan theta. So we can write cot theta is equal to cos theta divided by sin theta. If we find reciprocal of sin by cos, we get cos by sin, and reciprocal of tan is cot. It means cot theta is equal to cos theta by sin theta. So my dear student, moral of this story is, first you have to learn these trigonometric ratios. Sin theta perpendicular by hypotenuse, tan theta perpendicular by base, cos theta base by hypotenuse. You have to learn these trigonometric ratios. These are very important for this chapter. And similarly, cosec theta, sin theta is reciprocal of each other, sec theta, cos theta is reciprocal of each other, tan theta, cot theta is reciprocal of each other, then tan theta is sin theta by cos theta, cot theta is cos theta by sin theta. This you have to learn. Now, if we discuss, then how we get sin, cos, so we can see that this is about history of these ratios, or we can say names of these ratios. First, Aryabhatta gives the name Ardhjya. This is basically for half chord. Then with some time, it becomes Jya or Jiva. Then it becomes Sinus or Sine, and it resolved to Sine. And this abbreviation Sine is actually given by Edmund Gunter. So basically, this is about sine. Then Kotijya. Kotijya was defined by initially Aryabhatta. Then term cosinus or cosine were again given by Edmund Gunter, which with time is named as cos by Sir Jonas Murray. So this is about history of trigonometric ratios. The thing which is important, which you have to learn to solve the problems, is basically these formulas. What is sin theta, cos theta up to cot theta, and these simple relation between tan theta, sin theta and cos theta.